Welcome to the channel. Hit subscribe to catch all the exciting content we've got coming up. Drop a comment with topics you're excited about. We'd love to hear from you. So, you're working with three-phase motors, those heavy-duty, industrial-grade powerhouses that keep factories running, right? They're built tough, especially the TEFC type, totally enclosed fan-cooled, but even these rugged machines can break down. Why? Well, that's what we're diving into today. Let's talk about the top 5 reasons your three-phase motors could fail and, more importantly, how to stop that from happening. Let's get into it. Many industrial three-phase motors are built to start and stop repeatedly, but there are practical and recommended limits based on the motor's size, load, and thermal limits. Generally, most standard induction motors can handle between 4 to 12 starts per hour under normal operating conditions. Here's a killer for three-phase motors: too many start-stops. You've got your motor stopping and starting over and over again, and it's like asking your car to go from 0 to 60 every few minutes. That surge of power each time it kicks on creates a ton of stress on the motor. Every start sends a jolt of current through the windings, and if you're doing this too often, it's a recipe for a meltdown, literally. Each start-stop cycle generates heat, especially in the windings and rotor, which can lead to insulation breakdown over time. You want to limit the number of starts and stops if you can. If your setup requires frequent cycling, maybe look into soft starters or variable frequency drives, VFDs. They help ease the strain on the motor during those startup moments. If you haven't subscribed yet, now's the perfect time to hit that subscribe button. Now here's one that's a bit technical but super important: overload set too high. Every motor has a full load amp rating, FLA for short, which is the maximum current it should handle. But if your motor is running higher than its FLA consistently, you're overloading it. And that's bad news. Setting the overload too high is like overloading your truck beyond its weight limit. It might haul the load for a while, but the strain will damage it and lead to serious wear and tear. Here's how to calculate the correct overload setting for your motor. If the motor's service factor is 1.15 or higher, multiply the full load amperage by 125%. For service factors below 1.15, multiply the full load amperage by 115% instead. This ensures optimal protection and performance. Here's a sneaky one: lack of lubrication or using the wrong type. Motors have bearings inside that need just the right kind and amount of lubrication to function properly. Too little lubrication, and those bearings will start grinding and overheating, leading to premature wear and potential failure. Use the wrong type, and it won't provide the right protection, causing similar issues or even damaging the motor. Think of it like putting the wrong oil in your car, too little or the wrong kind, and the engine suffers. Check the motor's manual and use the recommended lubricant in the correct amount. Next up, overheating. TEFC motors have a pretty clever design where a fan cools the motor by pulling air over the casing. But guess what happens if that fan gets blocked? By dirt, dust, or whatever's lying around your workshop. It's like trying to run a marathon wearing a heavy winter coat. Everything starts overheating. When that motor heats up too much, the insulation on the wires inside starts to break down. And we all know what happens next: electrical failure. So make sure that fan stays clean and that nothing is blocking the airflow. Finally, let's talk about vibration. Motors, especially big three-phase ones, need to be mounted and aligned properly. If the motor isn't aligned with the machine it's driving, or if it's just loosely bolted down, vibration is going to be a problem. When the motor vibrates, all that shaking causes parts inside to wear down faster, and before you know it, you've got bigger problems like loose components or broken connections. Make sure everything's tightened up and aligned from the start, and monitor vibration periodically to avoid unnecessary wear and tear. So there you have it, the top 5 reasons three-phase TEFC motors fail: too many start-stops, overload set too high, too little or improper lubrication, overheating from blocked ventilation, and vibration from misalignment. Want to keep your motors running smoothly? Keep an eye on these issues, and you'll save yourself a lot of headaches and expensive repairs. If you like this video and found it helpful, give it a thumbs up, and hit that subscribe button for more tutorials, and thanks for watching.